Welcome to the unboxing of the AX5400 TP-Link Archer AX73 router. Let's look at the contents. Quick install guide. Note on the driver and Wi-Fi 6. This is an info card. Power brick. And let's pull out the router itself. There is also a network cable. Six antennas. This is the AX3000 for comparison. It's larger in size. Coming to the back panel from left to right, we have the LED switch, WPS switch, Wi-Fi on-off switch, the reset button, 4 LAN ports, 1 gigabit WAN port, an on-off button and the power port. Let's look at some of the key features highlighted on the box of the TP-Link router. So the first key feature is the flexible whole home Wi-Fi. So this router supports one mesh with which you can integrate and have a single SSID across the full area. It has 1.5 gigahertz triple core CPU and also the new standard of security, that is the WPA3 security, which has a superior encryption as compared to the earlier standard, and it also supports USB media sharing. In other features, we have 8K streaming support, so the gigabit Wi-Fi on this router can be used for streaming 8K content, and it also supports the other Wi-Fi 6 features such as OFDMA and also MoMeMo. It also has smart power saving and it's backwards compatible in terms of the earlier Wi-Fi standards. The router also supports TP-Link Home Shield, which includes network protection, parental controls and lots of reports. Now we have the AX73 connected to a 300 Mbps ACT broadband connection. Let's just do a quick speed test. Next, let's test the 2G. Next, we install the TP-Link Tether app from the Google Play Store and take a look at the features offered by the app. Let us now open the Tether app. So these are the wireless networks currently, the AX73 2G and the AX73 5G. This shows the settings. Next, it's showing the clients that are connected. Currently, only this device, which is the Galaxy Tab, that has been connected. This is the Home Shield option, and these are the tool options available on the TP-Link setup. There is a quick setup. This is the wireless setup that we saw just now. Then there is the actual internet connection. There is also the one mesh setup. There is network diagnostics, the guest network part of it. The LED control, it's possible to actually control these LEDs on the router. The operation mode, the router supports two modes. Currently, it's configured as the wireless router. It also can act as an access point. This is the reboot schedule, so reboots can be scheduled. Then these are some system settings. And lastly, for the advanced setting, it redirects to the web interface. So this is in brief the TP-Link app and the various settings that are available on the TP-Link app. Let's now take a look at one of the key selling points of this router, which is the support for TP-Link's One Mesh. One Mesh is something that intelligently connects the mobile devices to your router or extenders based on whichever is providing the best connection. Now let's compare with the traditional router with extender. In this kind of a setup, as can be seen on the left hand side, there would be two separate SSIDs, and the device will shift between two separate SSIDs. On the right side, as you can see, there is a single mesh or the one mesh, which means the TP-Link router can combine with a range extender such as the RE505 from TP-Link to form a one mesh network, which means you just have the single Wi-Fi name or the SSID throughout your house, and the devices will seamlessly move between the two networks internally. Now, as we can see, it is showing the available one mesh device as the RE505X. I just added it, and the configuration takes about a minute, and it's good to go. That's how simple it is to create the TP-Link one mesh. Next, I just wanted to highlight on the power adapter. This router comes with a 2.5 ampere 30 watt power adapter. Now I would like to share some findings of some readings that I've captured to compare the TP-Link Archer AX73 with the AX50. This comparison shows the comparison made on the 5 gigahertz band. And what you see here is the layout of the house. The router itself is placed here. The white lines are the walls, and the location icon shows the placement of the mobile phone from where the reading were captured. So let's start. So this is the router, and at the 2 feet distance, the readings from both the AX73 and the 50 are on par. So the 291/290 shows the download and the upload speed. As can be seen, it is same for both the routers. Then I took the next reading at a distance of about 25 feet. Here the AX73 shows a minor advantage with a slightly higher download and upload speed, but both the speeds are acceptable. Next, at the 33 feet range, again both are in the acceptable range, but the AX73 is once again at a higher level. Now what surprised me was the reading at the 38 feet mark, where the AX50 surpassed the AX73 and showed a higher reading. So and also I would like to call out that both these routers have been updated to the latest firmware update that is available from TP-Link, but still the AX50 surpassed the AX73. I hope this is a firmware issue and TP-Link will address this via a future update, but as it stands, the AX50 seems to provide a higher speed, better download and upload speed at the 38 feet mark. Next, I'd like to share the readings captured on the 2.4 gigahertz band. Here there was a lot more consistency. So at the 2 feet mark, both of them were on par, with the AX73 showing better download speed. Then at the 25 feet mark, again there was an advantage for the AX73 with slightly higher download speed. At the 33 feet mark, both of them were almost the same, with the 45 and the 37 download Mbps. And lastly, at the 38 feet mark, the download speeds were identical for both. However, the upload speed, the AX50 was lower, giving an advantage to the AX73. So I would say the AX73 performed better and more consistently on the 2.4 gigahertz band. To conclude, let's start with the pros and cons. The pros include the AX73 supports the TP-Link One Mesh, the AX50 does not, and also the AX73 has 6 antennas versus the 4 on the AX50. This also supports the latest WPA3 standard, which has enhanced security. Also, this has a better design and the cooling. So this runs cooler than the AX50 for sure. And there is also support for 4x4 MUMIMO versus the 2x2 MUMIMO on the AX50. Next, moving to the cons. So the AX73 is large and has a more bulkier design than the AX50, but definitely looks more attractive. And also, like I shared on the tests that I've done, I did not find the range to be considerably better than AX50. And also this router as well as the AX50 both do not support the range extender mode of operation. And this obviously is more expensive, being the more higher end device. So those are the cons. Thanks for listening. Until the next video, bye bye.